Bago magpasko, nagulantang na lang tayo at nalungkot sa biglang pagpanaw ng respetadong aktor na si Ronaldo Valdez. Ngayon pa lang sa linggong ito, nagbigay ng pahayag ang kanyang anak na si Jano Gibbs tungkol sa pinagdaanan nilang krisis.
Sabihin mo talagang iba na ang generation ng mga bata ngayon.
Isa siya sa pinakamahusay na aktor ng kanyang henerasyon.
Kayong malalapit sa akin, kung gagawa kayo ng lihis, ipatrabaho niyo sa iba, hindi yung kayo mismo ang gumagawa.
Mahusay sa drama. May ibang atake rin pagdating sa comedy.
Siguro pati yung mga balat ninyo nandiyan pa.
Wala naman kaming balat sa likod.
Wala? Tingnan ko!
Ay, tao eh.
Sa likod, hindi dyan.
Wala akong anak na bastos.
Ang premyadong aktor na si Ronaldo Valdez.
This is the one for me.
Pero bago natapos ang 2023, nagimbalang lahat sa isang masamang balita. Si Ronaldo Valdez, sa edad na 76 anyos,
I'm dying.
Sumakabilang buhay na.
Maswerte nga ako eh. Umabot pa ako sa ganitong edad eh.
Pumanaw na sa edad na 76 ang veteranong aktor na si Ronaldo Valdez.
Naging tahimik ang pamilya ni Ronaldo Valdez simula nung nangyari ang trahedya. Pero sa linggong ito, ang kanyang anak, ang singer at komedyanteng si Jano Gibbs, naglabas ng sama ng loob kung paano hinawakan ng mga pulis ang kaso.
Anong klaseng police station?
Inireklamo niya ang mga nagpakalat ng video ng mga huling sandali ng kanyang ama.
Kung isipin mo, malagim na nga yung nangyari sa amin. Dumoble pa, dinoble pa nila.
At mga nag-post din ng fake news kaugnay sa pagkamatay nito.
I do not wish this on anybody else. That's why I'm doing this. Ayoko nang mangyari sa ibang tao itong nangyari sa akin.
Nito lang Biyernes, pinaunlakan ako ni Jano ng isang interview para rin gunitain ang alaala ng kanyang ama. Jano, una sa lahat, maraming salamat.
Thank you, Miss Jessica, for having me.
Kamusta ka na? Kamusta ang inyong pamilya?
Holding up well. Nakatulong ng malaki yung right after. Nag-travel muna kami para makalayo, makalimot ng konti, makahinga. Malaking tulong yun. And now, hanggat maaari, hindi namin iniiwan ang isa na mag-isa. Kailangan may kasama. Nasa ganong stage kami.
You draw strength from each other.
Yes. Family is the biggest comfort for security.
Mabuti nagagawa mo ng humarap sa media at magpa-interview.
One, I had to come out with that press con to clear things, to air my grievances also. At least na ilabas ko na.
Kamusta na ako kayo?
Okay na ako.
Parang hindi pa eh.
Sabi kasi nila, Jano, merong different stages of grief, yes, di ba? Yes. May mga ganun ka bang pinagdadaanan?
I was even bashed for... Kasi we went on a trip right after the week. Eh, nag-post ako ng TikTok na sumasayaw. May mga nag-bash na, ano ba yan? Hindi man lang ilang araw pa lang. Yung iba yun, araw-araw na lang, nagpo-post na malungkot, nagdadasal na. You know, I didn't want to use the situation. So I wanted life to go on. Ang pinakita ko lang, that was one happy moment. But most of the times, we're still in grief.
Naalala ko lang, when you grieve, ang pinakamahirap kalaban yung thoughts. How do you erase the negative thoughts, the sad thoughts from your head?
You cannot. I think it will stay there forever. It will lessen. It will be fewer and far between as time progresses. Pero hindi na mabubura yun eh. Especially ako lang at si Bing. We saw him in that horrible state. The first night of the wake, siyempre, ako na yung parang padre de pamilya, di ba? Ako na yung, I was so strong. Nagugulat nga sila sa akin. Ang lakas mo, matapang ka, ganun. Second night, hindi ako nakapunta. breakdown. I still have once in a while flashes of the horrible image, but it gets lesser as time goes by.
You remember your last conversation with him? When was it? What was he like? Anong pinag-usapan niyo?
You know what? Kala nung iba wala ako doon eh, but he was living with me, diba?
Mm-mm.
I was just next door. And I think he made sure I was sleeping.
Oh my God.
He even knocked on my door.
Mm-hmm.
I was taking a nap, afternoon nap.
Mm-hmm.
So nagising ako, sumilip lang siya. Sabi niya, "Di ba tuloy yung lakad mo?" Sabi ko, tuloy. Kaya lang ginamit ni Bing yung kotse. Sabi ko, pagbalik, idlip lang ako. Ah, okay. Moments after that, eto na, yung driver, panicking. So I think he made sure natulog ako and wala yung driver.
If I can only turn back the hands of time, I will.
Jano, given yung circumstances surrounding the death of your dad, pwede bang matanong if there were signs prior, may pinagdadaanan, may nararamdaman, were there clues?
Since late last year, he was taping for his teleserye.
Mm-hmm.
He started, nahihirapan na siyang lumakad. Bigla. Okay. Mm-hmm. Bigla. No? Biglang parang, nagli-limp na siya. Got worse and worse until a few months ago, maybe, naka-mobile.
Wheelchair na nadadrive
yes.
Niya?
Yes, mm-hmm. Yeah, ganun na kami mamasyal.
Mm-hmm.
He could still climb the stairs, pero very slowly, very hard. No pain, but mahirap lang, mabigat. We went to several doctors. Ako, sinasamahan ko siya. Sabi ko pa, ikot na lang tayo ng ikot ng doktor. Kasi ayaw niya magpa-MRI.
Mm-hmm.
Takot yun sa M. Parang nako-claustrophobic siya. He even walked out in one session. Until finally, napilit ko siyang magpa-MRI. So he was scheduled to be operated on sa cervical...
Sa spine.
Sa spine. Mm-hmm. But the days before it happened, parang it was getting even worse. Mahilig mamasyal yun eh. But days before, pag niyayaya ko siya, hindi na lang. Medyo parang lalong sumasama yung ano ko, yung leg. To my guess, parang yun. Parang hindi na niya ma-take yung ano. He enjoyed life eh.
Mm-hmm.
He enjoyed living it, eating out, watching movies, mm-hmm. making pasyal. Siguro yung condition niya was getting worse. He couldn't take it. I'm just guessing, siguro ayaw niyang to burden us, his children, his grandchildren.
Mm-hmm.
Parang lalong ayoko na magpagamot eh.
Baka hindi niya kinaya yung prospect na
yeah, maybe he didn't
health
want the
problem
operation.
Siya
yeah,
o yeah. It's the immobility. Mga ganon.
For someone na layas, lakwachero,
mm-hmm.
it's a big thing for you to have a hard time just walking.
You know, Jano, nandun na tayo sa stage ng mga buhay natin na nabaliktad na yung roles, yung parents natin. From birth, sila yung nag-alaga sa atin. Now, role reversal na.
Yes.
Tayo na yung kanilang mga caregiver.
Yeah.
So, it may help if you share with us yung siguro yung mga nakita mo na prior. So, people will also know kung baka meron mga pinagdadaanan, may mga telltale signs.
After what happened, I've had people approach me na similar yung nangyari sa kanila.
Mm-hmm.
All had no signs. Kung meron man akong mapapayo, let's be more mapagmatsyag, mapagbantay.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi wala silang binibigay na signs. Most of the time.
Okay naman ako rito eh. At saka, mami ang konti lang. Aalis na rin ako eh.
No clues at all, no? So hindi totoo yung mga textbook na mga sinasabi nila
no.
Na you have to be more... Wala kang mga ganun na pinagdaanan dyan, no? Yung mga guilt na sana, ganyan. Wala kang mga ganun?
Wala. Because I feel I gave the best care, the best attention to him. Sa tingin ko, hindi ako nagkulang.
Mangyari, dinidibdib mo ang lahat. Ito, wala na. Nandito na ako eh. Huwag mo nang isipin, ha?
Kamusta sa bahay nyo? Kamusta pamilya nyo?
This is especially hard for me, for my family. Well, alam na naman ng karamihan, at least. not everyone. It's almost been a year na my dad and my mom have been separated already. After that happened, so almost 1 year nang nakatira sa akin ang daddy ko. I've been taking care of him. Okay. So, even harder, but also, I think it helped kasi, di ba, karamihan sa atin yung pag nawawala ng mahal sa buhay, sana mas nakapiling ko pa siya, sana mas sinamahan ko pa, di ba? Wala akong ganun because everyday kasama ko siya.
Pero mas mahirap din yun, no? Mas kasi mahirap mas maraming memories.
Balance.
Yung amoy niya, yung mga kaluskus ng paa niya, mga hinahanap mo. The little things and the little signs, di ba?
Yeah.
Natakot ako eh.
What I will miss most is our breakfast time together. Mm-hmm.
Paano kayo mag-almusal?
Dalawang unit kasi yung ano namin, yung house namin. So we were in one unit. Halika na, baba na tayo. Punta na kami sa kabila. Doon kami kakain. Tapos kwentuhan na about life.
Dekada 60 nung pasukin ni Ronaldo Valdez o Ronald James Dulaca Gibb sa totoong buhay ang pag-aartista. Ikinasal kay Maria Fe Ilagan at nagkaroon sila ng dalawang anak, sina Melissa at Jano. Gumawa siya ng kasaysayan sa showbiz nung nag-grand slam bilang best supporting actor sa iba't ibang major acting awards para sa pelikulang May Minamahal. Pero ang role na pinakabuong husay raw niyang ginagampanan para kay Jano, yun ay ang pagiging ama sa kanila.
You look familiar.
Baka ho kilala niyo yung daddy ko. Sikat din ho siya eh.
Paano ba maging tatay si Ronaldo Valdez? Tapos pareho pa kayong komedyante, di ba?
In GMA, he had a memorable sitcom, Yung Bahay Mo Ba To?
Mm-hmm.
I know he loved that show. Ikaw, Miss Jessica, kilala mo rin ako. Mm-hmm. Kilala mo ang daddy ko. Alam mo na ako, sa on-screen, I'm the comedian. Pero off-screen, you know, I'm, you know.
Serious. Well, like all comedians are.
Well, a lot. Yeah. Ang daddy ko, baliktad. Siya yung dramatic actor sa on-screen. Pero sa set yun, yun ang ano yun. Oh, ano? Kumusta kayo? Ganun. Siya yung life of the party.
Mm-hmm.
He was the comedian in the family.
Edi, ang saya.
Masaya. Ang saya nyo. We shared a lot of laughter.
And you were friends?
Yes. He is not the traditional father. Filipino father. Di ba yung... Diba ang tayo, mga Pinoy, yung mga tatay, medyo kinakatakutan. Mm. Yung pag sinabi kong, diba, hindi siya ganun. He was parang equal kayo. Even when we were small, kahit bata kami, equal, pwede kang mag-explain pag nagkamali ka. Pag naintindihan niya, naintindihan kayo tayo.
Cool dad pala si Ronaldo.
And very sweet, very affectionate. Very handsy, beso-beso, I love you. Diba, bihira yun eh. Pag-text kami, love you pa, love you, Jano.
Kaya nag-gold yan eh, dahil sa suporta at pagmamahal namin ng mama. Ang mama, bumili na lahat ng plaka.
Yun lang, yung fans, yung followers niya, yung viewers niya. Ang image sa kanya, kasi nga nalinya siya sa comedy in the latter part of his career.
Yeah.
Masayahing tao yan, si Ronaldo Valdez. Siya yung may punchline, kahit drama, siya yung patawa.
Miss... Mukhang nasiraan ka yata.
Parang may disconnect between the public perception of him and again, the circumstances surrounding his death.
He's a very emotional person. Sobrang sensitive to everything. I would even say a hothead once in a while. Impulsive. His last image that people remember is very horrible. Thanks to the leakages of ano.
Yung nangyari na leak ng video, unang-una, there is a violation ng kanilang internal policy. Meron po silang kakaharapin nung nakasong administratibo.
Jano Gibbs, umamin na sa kasalanan sa amang si Ronaldo. Inaamin ko ako ang mastermind ng lahat ng ito. Sumuko na, Jano Gibbs.
Mga vloggers, nagsishare, mga post katulad nung nangyari na yan, pwede po kayong umantong sa pagkakasala ng paglabag ng cyber libel law.
Somebody asked me, hindi ba dapat i-move mo yung playdate ng movie nyo mm-hmm. with my dad, no?
Yeah.
Too soon, ganun. Sabi ko, no, I think this is the perfect time to show it. Para mabura yung last horrible image of him and to see him again in his full glory.
Yeah.
Yung masaya, magwapo.
Hello, kumusta? Ganda natin ngayon, ah. You look fresh. Fresh from the grave.
Siya yung nagpapatawa na seryoso yung mukha, eh.
Yeah, Eh, alam mo naman kasi, pagka kuwan, eh, ano eh.
Kuhang-kuha mo, ah. Kuhang-kuha. Medyo hindi mo siya masyadong kamukha.
Medyo sa mother side ako.
Kami, magkamukha. Ito ang kamukha mo, si Panchito.
He was beloved not only by the family, but by his peers. Lately, si Catherine Bernardo was so close to my dad. And sa family, yung mga apo niya, mga anak ko, they were devastated with what happened. Kasi nga, sobrang sweet ng daddy ko. So loving. If you've watched Seven Sundays.
Yeah, napanood ko yun. Mm-hmm.
That was him.
Gusto ko, guwapo pa rin ako. Hanggang dun sa kabila.
I was watching it, I was crying. Yun siya, yun talaga siya mm-hmm. in real life. How loving he was there.
Siya yun.
Siya yun.
Wow.
That wasn't acting, that was him.
Para mag-cope sa pagkamatay ng isang loved one is really yung being open sa feelings, hindi kimkimin. So importante rin dito yung emotional support system.
So this one I took myself just recently. Sa room lang yan.
Ito kanong-kano siya.
Oo, mistiso. This one is very memorable.
Bakit?
Kasi my daughter, Alisa, did a collaboration.
Okay.
Yung abroad, ah.
Artist
abroad.
Siya.
Yeah, Na international ang release.
Wow.
So this was part of the apparel.
Oh.
So sabi ko sa daddy ko, pwede bang mag-pictorial tayo ng suot natin, damit ni nung apo mo? Oo, sige, game na game. Yan, sa bahay lang yan.
Ang galing.
Set-up lang ako ng ano. Paano ang post natin? Ganito. Astig naman. Tapos ganito. Ganon, nakakatuwa. Naglalaro lang kami habang nagpipictorial. And then this, yan ang madalas namin. He loved food. Mm-hmm. He loved, lalo na sweet. He had a sweet tooth.
Tingnan kung ano man yung pinaplano mo. At hindi ko makakayanang mawala ng anak.
Ang special nitong movie,
ha? Yeah.
Kasi first time mo mag-direct, tapos ang dinirect mo pa, tatay mo pa. What was it like?
This is the best parting gift he can ever give me. Supporting his son's dream. It was very special kasi first time ko mag-direct. Daddy ko pa na, you know, award-winning actor. So I had this nice, very nice memory of him. Meron kaming scene na medyo heavy in this movie. Confrontation scene. I wrote the story also, so before scenes, I would change some dialogue. Tapos sabi ko, padala niya na sa daddy ko sa tent for him to study. Pagdating dun, sabi niya, sino magaling na sumulat nitong dialogue? Maganda eh, sabi niya. So ako naman, kilig naman ako. So that was very special to me.
Nabasa ko yun eh, yung interview mo na yun. Tapos sabi mo dun, pinahirapan mo siya konti.
Medyo.
Tama ba?
Because we had action scene. Medyo dun ko siya pinahirapan. Although I put him in a wheelchair already.
Okay.
I made sure in the story that the dad he plays my dad also.
Mm-hmm, yeah.
Was in a wheelchair.
Ikaw din sumulat nito?
Yes po.
Pambihirang talent 'yun, ha? Nagsusulat na, nagdidirect pa, umaarte pa. Total package.
My grandfather is Jerry De Leon. He's our national artist for
paano
film.
Paano mo siya naging directing. Grandfather? Mother, father?
He's the father of my mom.
Parang hindi yun nababanggit, no? Hindi yun nasusulat sa'yo na apo ka pala ni the Jerry De Leon.
Yes, si Manong.
A much
Manong
respected national artist for movies.
So I hope also I'm making him proud.
May mga pictures siya dyan.
So I'm sure manonood siya ng movie namin. I could imagine us watching our movie together.
Do you have a last picture with him?
This was just recently, yeah. I think that was one of the last. Ganyan kami. See how relaxed we are and happy together.
Ang gwapo ng tatay mo, no? Ano to, may American blood?
Yeah, ayun, share ko lang. Not a lot of people know this. Ang daddy ni Ronaldo Valdez, Gibbs siya talaga. He never met his father. Parang GI baby, yun ang tawag natin, diba? All his life, he was looking for his dad, si Gibbs, si James Gibbs. He would do searches, and noon, mahirap, wala pang internet masyado, ganun-ganun. Until 2 decades ago siguro or more, finally may nagsabi sa kanya, nahanap ko yung father mo sa States. So sinulatan niya. Sumulat sa kanya pabalik na, I'm sorry, I have a family already here in the States. Sinabi ng daddy ko na, I'm not after anything. I'm doing really well here in the Philippines. I just want to meet you. So nagkita sila.
Talaga?
Ano na, I had a kid already.
Wow.
Ganon na kalayo.
Mm-mm.
Meron na akong panganay.
Mm-hmm.
That was very fulfilling to him. Mm-hmm. Hindi alam ng marami yun. So late in his life na nakilala niya yung father niya. It closed a lot of doors for him. And we even got to meet our lolo.
Your lolo.
Yeah, James Gibb.
Okay naman ako rito eh. At saka, mami ang konti lang. Aalis na rin ako eh.
Most valuable lesson learned from your dad and his life.
He loved life to the fullest. Ninanamnam niya lahat ng yung our moments together. Even food, he loved food. He loved everything. He loved traveling. He loved life. And he was very affectionate to us. He was my hero.
Gusto ko sana magkakasama tayo bago ako makipagkita kay San Pedro.
Is there anything meron ba na nire-regret mo na sana nasabi ko sa kanya?
Ano lang, ang wish ko lang is that I could have said goodbye. Said goodbye properly. In that state, in his horrible state, he was still breathing.
Okay.
And I stayed with him. I stayed with him for a good 10, 15 minutes. Yes, of course, wala nang response, but yeah, I got to say goodbye. I was kissing him. I was saying, I love you. I hope you're okay. You'll be okay na. But I wish I got to say those things nang conscious pa siya.
Pero if it's of any assurance, Jano, sabi nila, a person in the last seconds of his life daw, everything else goes except the sense of hearing.
Yeah.
Yun daw yung last to go, yeah, or one of the last to
I
go.
I know he heard me. Yeah.
Narinig ka niya.
Yeah.
Baka meron kang maipapayo sa mga families,
yeah,
out there, or the sons or the fathers out there na may mga mabibigat ding pinagdadaanan.
Yeah. Lalo na sa generation ngayon, no? Generation ngayon medyo ano na yung na-annoy sa parents nila, 'di ba? Ito naman masyado nakikialam, mm-hmm, ganun. Or they don't spend so much time with their parents. To the children, please spend more time with your parents. Love your parents. You'll never know when they go. I-cherish nyo na.
Guilty ako dun, ah. Tinamaan ako dun.
Sa lahat ng pagkakamali ko, kayo ang tamang nangyari sa buhay ko.
I wish yes. I interviewed you during a better time, Jan. Yeah. Pero maybe there's some message from somewhere about yeah. this. Na, ano. Hindi natin alam eh. Mahirap talaga explain yeah. eh, di ba?
If one good thing and importantly that came out of this was naging closer kami ng family ko.
Thank you, Jano.
Aalis ako. Masaya ako. Alam ko kasi kaya nyo na eh.